So finally, from morning to cold to jacket to wild wintry warning, red warning weather to the heat of the fire to the glow on the face. What took place but change? All that we are here is to accept change. The acceptance of change, meaning no beginning, no end, just constant change, is the permanent. And that's when the permanent and the still starts as still, starts as permanent, gains some sort of emotional, sensory thought, sensation, that the still is moving. And we fall into this ride, this body, to become part of the moving. When we believe, the mind believes, that it is the moving only, and has lost its permanence, its stillness, it gets flustered. Because what has taken place is nothing is really happening to what is in its true state. But the mind has developed a knowledge, an understanding, an intelligent way to say moving and still are two separate entities. And therefore, I have to move out of the moving into the still to attain the permanence that I once was. And of course, it happens in both ways. I'm bored, I'm still. I don't like this. Nothing is moving in my life. So I must look for the moving and get out of the still. That is ego. The ego is that what differentiates between movement and stillness. Enlightenment, facing up to your biggest fear, facing up to the truth, facing up that, you know what? I surrender to movement. I surrender to stillness. I give them both up. I relinquish my part on this earth, in this body. Because I've came to the point that the flower within me wants to blossom. But stillness and movement are opposing states, have to be overcome and seen through for the flower to get in. To the centeredness. But stillness and movement don't exist as opposites, as separates. But centeredness is one. I stumbled upon these words from a wonderful, wonderful speaker who, actually, it's not about this, the Osho in his book, The Secret of Secrets. It's not about his what Osho says. He points to Tao. And in all the videos and all the worlds I've tried to, this being, this human, has tried to share and get and sum up there are many ways to sum up, but I'd like to sum up with the Tao. And the Tao is speaking about the Great One, the Undivided. And the two opposite reality principles of dark and light and yin and yang. And he goes on to conclude about what our personal body existence is, what this is all about. And he writes this at the end. And this is what I would like to share as an experience, as our absolute 100% utmost knowing, that what the Tao says here is what it is for me, this one. He writes, if the life energy flows downward, that is, without let or hindrance, into the outer world, the anima is victorious over the animus. No golden flower is developed. If the life energy is led through the backward flowing process, that is conserved and made to rise instead of allowed to dissipate, the animus has been victorious. So that's the two ways. A man who holds the way of conservation all through life may reach the stage of the golden flower, which then frees the ego from the conflict of the opposites, and it again becomes part of the Tao, the undivided Great One. Beautiful, beautiful words from a master of not only in devotion, but in a specialized way of being able to share very simply. You see, I am what I am, a person of no intelligence, a person of no education, a person of no connection to anything before any of this took place. Not religious, not atheist, not already separate, already one, already that non-conformative to opposing states, that good and bad are indifferent and pain and pleasure are indifferent and still and movement are indifferent, but accepting of all that these things, because that's the world we have created, this two opposing states, this ego world, this ego state world that no mind is exempt from. So the vocabulary, the language from this one is taking over 900 videos to say in one paragraph what was experienced, what this is all about. Again, no one can speak on your part, you see. Osho speaks his language about what it is, as does Papaji, as does Shiva, Muhammad, and all the great speakers, but they're all speaking the same thing. They're all speaking about an ability, a hopefulness to try and share what is really unshareable, because it's down to each individual's experience and that ability to actually expose or project in a human limited mind and body way is extremely, extremely impossible, but it's the attempt to do it that makes it worthwhile, to keep each one of us pushing each other along to find our own individual truth. So that's about it, you see, from the hot, sparkling fire to the cozy old man, from the windy fields and water in the snow-filled land. It's an incredible journey. The idea of it ending is an opposite to beginning. Shall it end? Will it begin once it ends again? Or will it just simply transcend that whole divided, undivided one that just wallows about in itself through its own consciousness, creating so many different, beautiful, profoundly magical, mystical essence of qualities of life. Some are measuring life, some are valuing life, some are hating life, some are loving life. It matters not. No one can escape life. There is no end to life. There's an end to the ego mind, there's an end to the body, but it just recycled into that pot of undivided love that life is. Be kind to yourself, be kind to the world. Beat yourself up with a stick if you have to remind yourself of your true livingness, your true beingness, your true lovingness. Go through the motions, go through the trials, the tribulations, the challenges. Hate, love, be sad. Remember that Buddha and Jesus will not be remembered, but the parables, the words that are doors to each one of us in our escape route, so that we can join Jesus and Buddha. The whole of this is an experience of sharing, experience of words, experience of experiences, of experiences, experiencing thoughts in different ways, in different forms, in different actions, in different methods, in different practices, in different countries, in different bodies, in different colors, in different shapes, in different sizes. But the result, which is not really a result, the object is to nullify the opposing states and become one as that great divided one, undivided one. To become the tail, become the moment, become consciousness in its whole pure life ways of replicating and reflecting the truth that one is. I can now go back to speaking my local tongue as the stick falls out the fire. That reminds me. Before I burn the house down. It is a great ending to say stop. In the last video, the door opened. Someone knocked at the door. And that's what happens in awakening and enlightenment. The door opened. And I was on the outside, looking inwards. Both ways. The fire. Is that what reminds us? It's not in the end of the stick. It's in the smouldering. It's in that moving sense of burning. That brings us home. A place where we've never left. This is home. This is primary home. When you see it all as one thing, the universe is home. Consciousness is home. And we have a small home with a fire burns to remind us of our home that we are. Be here. Take your words and burn them. Throw them out the door and welcome that what stands on the other side in. And meet yourself as one. And all opposites burn with the stick and remain as ashes. What a way to end. End. What can end? That's a better way to end. Question end. What can end? Can end end? Can now be anything but now? Can I be anything but I? Can one be anything but one? And can love be anything but love? Final words is what was spoken from the beginning. From the first realization then of awakening. And the words came from somewhere colossal. Only consciousness exists. What else is there to know? No more questions. No more answers. No more seeking. No more wanting. No more desiring. No more. In fear. No more living in fear. No more worry. No more suffering. Everything else remains the same. Pain and pleasure will come and go. But it will remain the same. You don't overcome the human body. You don't overcome this ability to be here as this form. But you see through it. You smell through it. You hear through it. And you recognize through it. Through it meaning it's a fake. What is the most precious fake that's worth getting to know? From both sides. From the center. Now I'm off to do as Buddha says. You can remove both sides. Then you become centered. Can one remove center? Can one totally remove that what holds all of this together. What can do it? Who can do it? Where can it be done? Can it be done? In Buddha's words, it shall be done. I love you all immensely. It's a privilege to speak on behalf of whatever it is that we are, that we serve, that we are proud to be. A message to every single human being: be. Simply be.